The tail of a scalpel. Nothing was I but a piece of metal. Until I was carved into a spectacle, sculpted to finesse, molded into a beautiful scalpel was I. The beauty gave me no satisfaction, not until the tail was hands, chose me from the green cloth tray. My sharp edge cut through the tumor, a tumor of brain, they say. Those articulate fingers handled me with care. When I looked up to see my master above, not once had I felt so loved. His lips were concealed beneath the mask, but I could see the impression of a laugh. "She's safe," I heard him say, and though bathed in blood, I finally felt satisfaction come to me. Years went by, so many successful surgeries to my name. I had cut through skins, shed so much blood, but all for the patient's well. It was that fateful day when the ECG flattened. Those gifted hands had done all to save the patient. No sooner did he open the doors, in rushed people in schools. I was snatched up from the tray, my blade cut across a face. In a frenzy, I looked up to see my master shielding a cut. I watched in horror as the relative brandished me. I screamed when they struck me into my master's heart. My master fell and I was thrown beside him. The killer and the killed left to mourn and grovel. He touched me gently one last time, consoling me as I wept. He said, "You're not a killer. You're not a knife. You're the scalpel. Take pride. Raise your voice. Stand strong, for it is a legacy that you have to continue in the midst of these demons."